So Loma beat Ortiz, now hopefully fights Haney. Zepeda, who does he fight?
Ryan.
Zepeda and Ryan? You think that's the fight to be made? What happens
in
that fight?
The Golden Boys.
Who wins?
I don't know, that's why. They gotta
Ryan smokes him.
Ryan has the one.
Ryan smokes him.
Ryan has the left hook that put anybody's lights out, but Zepeda doesn't stop, man.
Well, you get stopped, you get, no, he goes to sleep.
We'll have to see, and then if it gets past the fucking third, fourth round, and Ryan's left hook isn't the, you know, we saw that with Nonito after 3-4 rounds, and he starts to slow down a little bit. The power's not the same, the speed's not the same, and fucking Cepeda's not gonna stop. So that's
Ryan had the knockout last fight in what, round 5-6?
Yeah, something like that.
So Ryan's good. Ryan got this, but that's the fight you want to see?
Yeah,
if there's no tank fight, of course.
Yeah, but no, it's not gonna be a tank fight. So
no, they'll fight. Why do you think they're not gonna fight?
Not next.
No, not next, but after
that's
that.
That's what I'm saying. He's a southpaw. Get him ready for tank.
Like the last two opponents.
And if they don't want to do that, if Ryan and his team Golden Boy stay away from that, then Golden Boy doesn't have other 135 pounders for him. They don't have anybody besides Ryan. So send him over to Top Rank and let him fight fucking Shakur Stevenson. Let him fight one of those. You got the difficult, you know, hard to hit style with Shakur Stevenson, but now he's moving up another weight class. Cepeda's big for the weight class, and he's not gonna stop throwing. I think you'll see the best of Shakur and the best of Cepeda in that kind of, fight. Yeah, at 135.
Shakur's very talented.
Yeah, Shakur's. I think Shakur's, you know, I'm talking about Devin Haney. I think he's gonna beat, you know, what's name, pretty easy and stuff.
Loma.
I think Shakur's even better still.
So Shakur beat Haney, you think?
I would maybe pick Shakur.
How about this? They compare Devin Haney to Mayweather. They compare Shakur to Mayweather. Out of both of them, who's closer to Floyd?
I think defensive-wise, I think neither one of them is like Floyd. They're different because at the weight class when Floyd was at 135 and stuff, he was a power puncher. He was a strong dude. Neither one of them is a power puncher. The defense, I think Shakur has a better defense than Devin Haney, but he's also a southpaw. Neither one of them is. I don't think either one of them is similar to Floyd, unless you just say, "Oh, they have good defense." Like, okay, but Floyd's had a great defense, and at 135, he would completely fucking knock you out. So neither one of them, I think, is. They're not good comparisons. I think you could go with, you know, there's other styles and stuff.
I don't like when people compare people.
Yeah, I don't.
Because
like
it, you could be the first Shakur, not the second. Kobe was the first Kobe.
Devin Haney, oh, he has to
50
be like,
and oh, 0,
nah,
and
fuck that. Like, he's doing his own thing. Shakur's doing his own thing.
It's a compliment.
Devin Haney, oh yeah, Floyd and stuff, and you can say, oh, he might not get to 50-0, but he's 23 years old, he's the undisputed champ at 135. Floyd was never an undisputed champ. So you could also say, like, well, I already did this, and yeah, but then you just start, it's done.
But then you start
just
comparing opponents.
Just appreciate
and, yeah,
what each guy's doing at their time. That's
I
it.
Agree.
That's all you can do.
But right now, boxing, we need big fights, Pita. I need big fights. It's hard to get fans excited.
We should have had fucking November 19th. We should have had fucking Errol Spence versus Terrence.
That would have been
December,
massive.
December 3rd, 10th, or the 17th, Ryan versus Tang. Early next year, we should have had fucking Usyk versus Tyson Fury. And
instead, we get Fury Chisora. You couldn't pay me to watch that. Pita, you couldn't pay me to watch that.
Now we get Fury Chisora. We're going to get
we know what's
Terrence
gonna
Crawford versus Avanesian.
That I'll watch. I'll fucking pay for that one.
I'll pay for it just because it's fucking Crawford. And we're going to get fucking Errol Spence versus either Keith Thurman or Stanionis. That one's going
to
be
what if Spence moves up to 54?
Nah, he said he's staying at 135.
Okay, how does he do with Stanionis?
He beats him, but it's not. Those are competitive fights.
Thurman?
Spence Champion. Will handle them.
Well, the promotion for Thurman will be sick because they both talk and they both talk
but
trash.
But I think they're going to end up losing Stanionis because they're mandatories. They're mandatory.
So you don't lose your belt.
Fighting. Yeah, he can't lose the belt. He's going to end up fighting, I think, Stanionis. Stanionis has a great jab. He's going to be there all night. I just think Errol's just too. He's on another level. So I would favor Errol. But we should have got Errol versus Crawford. And fucking Avanesian versus Stanionis.
The thing is, we can only watch the fights we get. And right now,
choose to all the fans and stuff. If they really don't like the fights coming up, don't watch them.
They're going to watch him.
Show the network, show the promoters and shit that
they're still
really
going to
like what they're putting on and don't watch. But they should, that's what they should do. That's what they really should do.
But fans are not going to do that, Pita.
They have to do it. If you don't like
okay,
fight,
what do you think about, way off the subject, Conor Ben failing 2 tests, not 1?
Fuck
that. He said contamination was a mistake. It happens.
Fuck that. I don't want to do that.
It's hard to believe when you fail twice. He's a nice guy. I met him in person once.
He was here sparring for...
Seems like a nice guy, but we don't know what happens. We don't know who gives him what.
It's fucked up.
Maybe he thought it was legal. It's women's... pregnancy medication for fertility.
Some shit like that. I'm supposed to, I don't know. Charles knows more about it.
Charles
about it. I'm gonna tell you exactly what they use it for. women use it for what they use it, but he'll tell you exactly why.
Where's Charles at?
Charles, he explained it to us the other day, but I don't fucking remember.
Okay. All right, guys. Pita, where they follow you at?
Follow my dad, Garcia Box.
Thank you. Follow on November 18th. Don't miss it. San Antonio,
November Garcia. November 18th in San Antonio, Texas. We have our event, headline, main event, Hector Tarajada. Fighting in San Antonio.
Beef, like fighting, everyone fighting.
Home main event will be Biggie. On there, we have Sylvester Quiñones. We have Arterita, we have Daniel Cortez, B-Fly's on there.
You think Chima gets licensed in MMA? No?
MMA?
Yeah.
Yes? They had a guy fight with one eye the whole time. Fighting, what's his name?
Leo's fighting in San Antonio.
Who's the guy with the one eye? Bisping.
One eye. He doesn't have one eye.
He's blind in one eye.
Is he fully blind?
Bisping?
Is he fully blind in one eye?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know.
He has a glass eye. It's not even real.
He's completely blind in that eye?
Yeah. It's not even a real eye.
Oh, shit. Something, but I don't know who's blind. I thought it was like, oh, he has bad vision or some shit, but blind?
Chema would be the pound-for-pound king if he fights in MMA.